You've completed your COVID test at an MIT medical testing facility and checked in at the front desk of your residence hall or moved into your FSILG. Your stuff is in your room. Now what? No doubt you have many questions. You can find more detail about life on campus in the campus guide at studentlife.mit.edu/UGguide. Here are some essentials you need to know. Also, if you are moving into one of three houses in the FSILG pilot, this information applies to you too. MIT requires that all students quarantine for a period as soon as they move into their rooms. We call this period Q Week, and it ends on February 22nd. In-person classes begin on March 1st. This period helps ensure that you and other students in on-campus housing or in one of the FSILG pilot houses do not have the COVID-19 virus. But what does quarantine entail? This video will clarify what is inbounds and out of bounds during Q Week. If you have questions, please contact your area director or the FSILG office to discuss activities or actions before you engage in them. No one wants to make students quarantine. However, it's a necessity due to the ongoing global health crisis and a condition of living in on-campus housing. By following these instructions, you can protect yourself, your friends, and other community members from infection. First, you must remain in your room with your door closed, with just a few exceptions. More on that soon. Whenever you do leave your room, you must wear a face covering. Face coverings are mandatory in all common spaces in your residence hall and FSILG, in MIT facilities that you are authorized to access, and anywhere else on MIT's campus. Massachusetts requires face coverings to be worn in public at all times. Second, you cannot have direct contact with anyone else except your assigned roommate if you have one. That includes people in your residence hall or FSILG, staff except for front desk workers and MIT medical staff under specific conditions, and friends living off campus. You can contact house team members or the FSILG office through email if you need to. Third, you cannot visit friends' residence halls, FSILGs, or off-campus apartments, or go to restaurants or cafes. Other colleges have reported that the primary mode of virus transmission is casual, extended contact with friends in social settings. So we encourage you to pack everything you need, toiletries, bedding, snacks, and whatever else will help you during Q Week. Also, you can order food and have other stuff delivered to your residence. Fourth, stay in your room as much as possible, except when using your assigned bathroom, getting packages from the desk or food from your dining facility, or going outside for exercise. We know this might be hard, and if you need support, all of the ones that you know and love are still available. Visit studentlife.mit.edu/support for more information. Lastly, you must attest to your health condition daily on the COVID Pass app, accessible through Atlas. Check out covidpass.mit.edu for more details. A word about food. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner will be available in your residence hall Monday through Friday of Q Week. The hours are 7 a.m. to 10 a.m. for breakfast, 11 a.m. to 2:30 p.m. for lunch, and 5 to 8:30 p.m. for dinner. For Q Week only, Monday through Friday breakfast is complimentary. On the weekends during Q Week and beyond, brunch is available 9:30 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. and dinner is available from 5 to 8:30 p.m. When you leave your room to pick up food, make sure you are wearing your face covering, which is required anytime you are outside your room. If you live in one of the FSILG pilot houses, your meal service information will be sent to you. Until the end of Q Week on February 22nd, you will need to take your grab-and-go meals back to your room. If you need a break from your room, you can leave the building for a short time, about an hour each day. Please make sure you are wearing a face covering at all times, and if you meet someone you know, stay 6 feet apart from each other, or about 1.1 smoots. Just for Q Week, you should ignore the automated testing prompts from Atlas and wait to take your second COVID-19 test 7 days after your first test, but please attest every day. Make sure that you have MIT Atlas loaded on your smartphone or tablet, and that you can find COVID Pass on the MIT Atlas app. COVID Pass and your MIT ID are the keys to getting tested and accessing your residence and other on-campus spaces. Assuming that your second test comes back negative, you will be able to leave quarantine, but no earlier than February 22nd. Subsequently, you will have to get tested twice a week to comply with requirements to remain in residence and to maintain access to campus facilities. Please follow a regular testing cadence according to automated testing prompts from Atlas to maintain access to your residence and other campus facilities. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner will be served each weekday in your residence starting February 15th. Please know that East Campus residents will take their meals in Walker Memorial. Brunch will be served in your residence on Saturdays and Sundays. You can also get lunch on the meal plan starting on March 1st in the Lobdell Dining Hall in the Student Center using the Get app. Lunch is available by pre-order only. To download the Get app, visit studentlife.mit.edu/getapp. FSILG residents in the pilot houses will get meal information sent separately. Additionally, Dunkin' will be open in the Student Center. Check the retail dining section of studentlife.mit.edu/dining to see what's open and where. We know that these conditions may feel isolating, so we are excited to share that the residential pod program, which was successful during the fall semester, will continue during the spring semester. The program allows up to 6 residents of the same building to socialize in certain settings that do not require 6 feet of physical distancing or the use of face coverings. Information about the FSILG pod program will be sent separately. Your area director or FSILG pilot planning team should have already reached out to you detailing the process on how to form a pod, which can be created at any time during the semester. Once Q Week is over, your approved pod may be assigned a lounge or other space specifically for your pod's use. Additionally, you can hang out in your pod mate's rooms and eat in your designated common space without face coverings or physical distancing. Please visit studentlife.mit.edu/pods for more information. If you need a break from your room, you and your pod mates can leave the residence hall or FSILG. Please make sure you are all wearing face coverings at all times, and if you meet someone you know who is not in your pod, stay at least 6 feet apart. Keep in mind that your pod members cannot go into other pods' private rooms or designated spaces unless specific protocols are followed. See your house team for more information. And your face must be covered and physical distancing practiced when you are anywhere outside your room or your pod's designated spaces. MIT will monitor conditions and compliance to ensure that everyone is doing their part to limit the spread of infection. Any student who is not following MIT COVID-19 policies may be referred to the Committee on Discipline and possibly removed from institute-approved housing. With living on campus or in an FSILG pilot house comes a serious responsibility to keep the virus at bay. MIT urges you to help your neighbors and community by wearing a face covering whenever you are away from your room, maintaining a physical distance of at least 6 feet from others, completing the health attestation form daily, practicing enhanced personal hygiene, completing a COVID test when required, and following the rules in your residence hall or FSILG pilot house. We wish you all the best for a productive and healthy spring semester. If you have further questions, please consult the campus guide at studentlife.mit.edu/ugguide.